Hi, I'm Larry London. This is Border Crossings. For today's show, I welcome two brothers and a longtime friend who call themselves Chase Atlantic. Mitchell and Clinton Kay formed Chase Atlantic in 2011 in their native Australia, along with schoolmate Christian Anthony. They released several EPs, which caught the attention of Joel and Benji Madden of the Madden Brothers in 2015, when Chase Atlantic competed on national television on The X Factor. And in 2017, they released their self-titled debut album. Today, we get a chance to meet Chase Atlantic, and we'll be treated to several live songs. Stick around. This is Border Crossings. Hi, welcome to Border Crossings. My name is Larry London. They're on tour for a brand new album, and they're here in Washington. Chase Atlantic, join us in Washington, D.C. Welcome, guys.
Thanks for having us.
It's great to have you here, and congratulations on the debut album, which
Thank
has been
you.
Out now a number of months.
Yes, we worked very, very hard on that, and it's great to see it living.
Now, you guys are from Australia, and have you had a chance to tour in the U.S. often, or is this the first time? Or?
Yeah,
we haven't actually toured too much in our life. Span as a band. We're a production band, so predominantly working in a studio. And
we toured a couple times back in Australia, but this we only really started touring like 4 months ago.
Yeah, and the US was our first proper tour.
Oh.
It was with Sleeping with Sirens, and it was.
But I feel like we've grown a lot. We've grown a lot since that started, which is which is great. So we can ask.
Can you introduce yourselves so that the audience knows who we're seeing and hearing?
Yes, I.
Any camera?
This camera here.
All of them. I think
this is your favorite camera. It'll find you.
Well, I'm Clinton, and I'm the oldest member of the band, and I play saxophone and lead guitar and production.
Yeah.
I don't know why I said that first bit.
I'm Mitchell. I sing, play a little bit of bass guitar when I have to, a little bit of production, and just an overall great guy. Please date me.
Christian, I play guitar and sing.
All right, well, see, kept it simple. Kept it nice
and
simple.
You have a nice little touch at the end, like, and I love fishing.
I play good guitar.
I love fishing.
Now, you two are brothers.
Yes.
And so has it always been the plan to perform together, to have a career together? Or
it just worked easier.
Yeah, it just worked its way out naturally. Mm-hmm. And then we found Christian, our third brother.
Now, you guys met where? School, or how did you come together?
It was a very bizarre.
We bonded over Skrillex.
Yeah.
We really like Skrillex. Mm-hmm. And it was just the time of dubstep.
And we're like, we got to make this music, man. We got to make this music.
Now, you write your own stuff. You write, produce, and create your own music, which
Everything.
Is great. And now you've just got, you got a major label deal, which every artist in music seeks.
It's incredible because we got the major deal, but we're still allowed to write, produce, mix, and do the whole thing.
That is great.
I don't know why they trust us, but they do.
And this has been, you guys have been in the process for a while. I think 2011 is kind of when you actually started this whole thing.
Yeah, it's one of the
Chase Atlantic has been together since 2014, but we've been making music together since around 2012. Yeah, around then.
A lot of corny YouTube comments.
Yeah,
that's right. Millions of people follow you on YouTube.
You can't go finding that stuff. It's deep.
It's all private now. Luckily,
we deleted it all.
There's still some of it out there though. It needs to be gone. YouTube, if you're watching this, get rid of it.
Well, YouTube's great. For your generation, you guys are all in your 20s now, so you're very young, and you don't know how it was before YouTube. This is kind of all you know is
the
social media age.
We grew up with YouTube.
And so this has really helped you guys out considerably. A lot of people have been discovered through YouTube and social media.
It's insane.
Yeah. Justin Bieber.
It definitely has its benefits, but it, I think it's definitely saturated the industry a little bit.
Oh, yeah. It's like SoundCloud.
So it's hard as well. It's like...
Everything.
There's more people able to do things now, and there's more competition, and there's just too much out there now, you know what I mean? Mm. Which is not a bad thing, but...
Good. You gotta stay on your toes, stay creative, stay unique.
How did you come up with the name Chase Atlantic? What's the reason behind the name?
There's no real cool meaning.
Every bad name's taken, man.
That was left. So
This is the only bad name left.
Random. We did name generator. We just went through
a bunch of words.
Names.
So give us some of the choices. What could you have been?
We were going to be
the Dalliance.
Would have been weird.
What was the other one? Something about a weekend.
Oh yeah, the Royal Weekend or something.
Just random
words that we liked.
And they were very punky. Even Chase Atlantic's a very punky name, I feel like. But
now we've done this stuff, it feels less associated. It feels more of like a I feel like the more you create music, the stronger you build your name and the more confidence you have in it.
Mm-hmm. I mean, what a name that didn't really represent anything at the time, so that when we did become bigger, it could represent just the band. You'd think instantly of the band, like Coldplay or something
At
like
one
that.
Point, I was like, oh, we change the name again. We have to change the name again. But then we solidified the music, and I was like, actually, it works perfectly. Mm.
And so how do you define your sound? Because I've read where you guys, you know, you incorporate the sax into what is rock, and you've got a number of different sounds that you
It's really tough.
Primal like, Bliss.
Primal Bliss primal is what bliss. Someone said. But that's, I feel like that's not descriptive enough.
That's a new
nocturnal
channel.
Nocturnal pop.
It was like dark.
Aesthetic. Nocturnal. Dark aesthetic.
Dark R&B and Primal Bliss. But like, it's more pop and rock in there. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's a bit of everything.
Bit of
we
everything.
Do what we can. We right. try.
Well, we're happy to have you in our studio. So if you guys wouldn't mind doing a song for
us.
Chase Atlantic live here on the Voice of America.
So are we doing three songs now?
Yeah, absolutely. We can do three, four, we can do ten. Whatever
do
you
one right now,
are in the mood
now,
for.
Oh, yeah. Should we start with The Old Thinking About You?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Tornado flew around and boom before you came. Excuse the mess you made. Usually doesn't rain in Southern California, much like Arizona. My eyes don't shed tears, but boy they bawl when I'm thinking about you. Oh no no no, I've been thinking about you. You no no no, I've been thinking about you. Do you think about me still? Do you, do you? Do you not think so far ahead? I've been thinking about forever. Oh, oh, oh. Do you not think so far ahead? Too cool enough to kick it. Got a beach house I can sell you an idol. You think I don't love you, I just start too cute, that's why I kiss you. Got a fighter jet, I don't get flying online. Cause I'm thinking about you. Oh no, 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 I've been thinking about you. You no, 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 I've been thinking about you. Do you think about me still? Do you not think so far ahead? I've been thinking about forever. Oh, oh, oh. Do you not think so far ahead? I've been thinking about forever. Remember, how could I forget how you feel? So you were my first time, new feel. And it will never get old, not in my soul. My spirit keep me alive. We'll go down those roads and it turns from color to black and white.
Chase Atlantic, sounding great.
A little smooth.
Yeah, I like that. Very smooth and easy.
Yeah.
So I mean, is that kind of nice. That's what the show's like? Is that when you do a concert, no, or you guys rock out, go crazy, around, bounce off the walls?
We go crazy.
This is the Chase Lennon Cafe.
This is the cafe.
The cafe. Yeah.
Well, I like it.
Also being the cafe boys.
Yeah, well, thank you for doing this for us, for coming in. I know that you guys are operating on fumes because you guys haven't had much sleep, which is the nature.
I got an hour sleep.
You got an hour, a whole hour.
It was great.
We played in New York, and this happens when in New York.
New York's a great time. So
great.
The show is wild.
Amazing. Yeah,
tour been going great for you?
Yeah. Fantastic.
So how about the American audiences? They've been very receptive to you guys?
The American audience are the best audiences that we know.
Really?
We've never been to Europe, but it's definitely tough in Australia. The crowds there are definitely a lot more...
They're a bit more cool.
A bit more cool, yeah. Harder cool
to impress.
Yeah.
You have to be a bit bigger to... impressive.
Yeah. But you guys are huge, right? You got famous on The X Factor in Australia.
We did, but like we had to restart from that. Like that took us to a place and then we went all the way back.
That taught us kind of what not to be like.
That really?
We really made us think about our lives and if we want to be genuine musicians, because that stuff's not really, it's not real.
It's not real.
It's more of just like a quick 5 seconds of here, can you sing? Oh, I guess you can sing. Get on the show.
I mean, even
like filming a bunch of stuff, but
there's so much more in it than that. It's like
it takes so much more to be a musician. Like someone who wins X Factor in Australia, for instance, they can't. Nothing happens with their life. It just slowly degrades, and then they get lower than when they started.
Wow, that's interesting.
It's a sad truth of the.
Because it's a popular TV show. Yeah, it's been on for a number of years. So.
It's a popular TV show for singing and for for being singing and looking good. But there's a whole.
There's no artistry.
So much.
It.
Yeah, you need. There's a difference between being an artist and a singer. Like
these people don't know how to make music. Yeah. Don't know how to produce songs.
Like, right. Who are the judges, or who were the judges when you were on? Do you remember?
We had Mel B, Ronan Keating, Guy Sebastian Natalie. Natalie
Bassingway,
yeah.
Did anybody say anything that you could take away and learn from or grow from or
they
no?
Said,
or
was it just work on your singing?
Work on your singing. That was it. Work.
Well, our managers Joel and Benji were judges on
The Voice.
On The Voice in Australia.
A competitor show.
That's not how we met them.
Right.
They were just conveniently.
The Madden brothers, referring to the Charlotte.
It was interesting to watch them. Like we'd hang out with them backstage and
we watched the whole thing all over again.
Unfold in front of our eyes, and we kind of just like laughed about it. Not laugh at the show, but it was just funny to say like, hey, we've moved on to a better part of our lives.
We've had to grow so much to get back to where we are now, and we're doing better than we ever have.
That's great.
Than we were on the show.
And the one bit of advice, not saying from who. Particular, so I don't say names, but was just keep doing what we're doing and don't be on the show. You don't want to be
on the show. It's fun, but don't expect much out of it.
Well, it's hard to actually put yourself out there like that because you have a good attitude, which is healthy, but there are those who are kind of vulnerable, thinner skin. You're being judged on a national TV
really
audience.
Tough. It's really
practice in the shower.
It's real brutal.
that's all I can say. Just when you're in the shower, pretend you're doing it.
And then you were Boston singing in the shower the other night by Christian.
Never happened.
Never happened. Can't remember what it was. Mm. Never happened.
All right. Well, I read now, let's go back to the album, the new album. I read where your perspective on the album, production is always the first and most important thing.
Yeah, that's
for you guys.
Why did you read that? It's amazing. I didn't know that was like a
Yeah, they quoted you as the production.
We didn't say that, we just don't remember saying it.
You don't remember saying
but
it.
But we did mean it. I do agree with that.
Yeah, it's very true. Like, we produce, like, a track, and then we're like, if this sounds good enough, this can be a genuine song with lyrics and melody. Because I feel like a lot of the key element to a good song is the production.
Mm. So what's the songwriting process for you like, guys? Do you work together? Do you come up with an idea?
So, like,
you come up with a house?
Christian and I will sit in a room. On Ableton, at Ableton Live, and we'll flesh out like an instrumental, we'll put a whole bunch of nice synths and like program drums, and maybe like I'll record some like demo guitar in there that Christian like has ideas for, and then we'll bring it over to Clinton, who's working in the other room across from us on Logic, and he'll kind of retrack all the guitars and stuff, all the organic things, and then
So we
slowly finesse that, and then it just builds and builds and builds, and then we
usually starts with an instrumental, that we're happy with before the vocal and writing and recording.
Sometimes we have to go back into Ableton again and tweak some stuff and then bring it back into Logic. But it's a great thing because I don't know many people who do that. Mm-hmm. So I feel like that's
your process. Mm-hmm. So it's interesting. You know, I admire songwriters. I have great respect for songwriters because you create a sound. You know, like you say, the music, the melody.
Yeah.
Then you have to find words that fit into the framework
of the melody.
That's
what makes it easier for us because we make the instrumental and it gives us a mood. Right. It gives us like a feeling, and we're like, this is what we're gonna write about. It gives me this kind of feeling. Let's write about it.
The new kind of wave as well of like writing, especially with Mitchell, who does most of the lyrics and melody stuff, is just do it at the same time. Like you might like sing a little bit of a melody, but then just kind of come up with words. It's not like. I couldn't imagine like writing words and then like
and then
using
like,
those words.
Alright, I'm gonna use these words to come up with a song. I feel like that. There's definitely people who can do that. Don't get me wrong, but
Mitchell does it at like the same time though. Like he'll be listening to the song and just kind of walk around the room. And, like, sing
I could
some
never like write lyrics and then be like, I've kind of write a song to these lyrics because it gives you nothing to work around. You have to really be strict to what you wrote and be like, how's this rhyme scheme work in this beat? Like,
and one of the songs on the album is autobiographical. It's kind of about. You know, your story?
Into it?
Into it.
It's a very kind of vague,
very short story.
Very vague.
A short story.
We're into it. That's the one.
And it's more of just like a pleasing song as well. Yeah. But it is about a lot of songs on the album are about our lives. It's kind of exaggerated in a way. And
it's a big change to move from Australia to LA.
We get to tell all our stories. If we're feeling sad, we'll make a sad song. If we're feeling happy, we'll make a happy song. Mm.
What's the biggest change? That's a great comment. It was a big change. Well, how so?
I mean, being away from our families. Obviously, you guys were living in Brisbane, so you'd been away for a bit.
Christian's a bit younger, so it was his first time out of home.
Just out of home and just like completely moved.
So he finished high school later because he's from Sydney and we're from Queensland. So in Queensland, you kind of finish school and then you leave straight away because we grew up in a small town. Mm. But Christian finished when he was 18, which is probably better, honestly.
Mm-hmm. So I finished
and you have more time
and got drafted straight out of high school to Warner Brothers and then moved over there.
Wow.
Well, actually by John and Benji.
He loves the word drafted.
Yeah, like
a big basketball fan.
That's a big change as well. Bath to sports is completely different.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's better.
I know way more about basketball than I did when I was in Australia.
It's probably the biggest change.
Thanks to him.
So other than basketball and being a little bit of homesickness, what else has changed for you now that you've come over from Australia to the U.S. and you're making a splash here in America?
It's a drastic lifestyle change, especially on tour, because we grew up as nice little boys. Like we're going home cooked meals and hanging out, just having a good time. But now it's like full on every night. Where can we find food? What's going on the bus?
Ice coffee.
Driving.
Give me some ice coffee.
Like, it's really rewarding, but it's tiring. It's really tiring.
Right.
That's the biggest change.
And every night, people are there to party with you because that's their one night they've dedicated to partying, and then it becomes a thing every night.
And they leave, and the next group they want to party, you have to party with.
Yes,
it's the one part of our lives where we're really not looking after our bodies.
That's all good. We're still in the early stages as well, so we're just in a little bandwagon at the moment. But once we get to upgrade to get that big bus,
it's over for you, boy.
The bandwagon's it's like an RV. It's got like a television shower and beds and stuff, but just want to upgrade so we get those lounges.
Mm. Just want to lounge.
Just want to lounge.
Here we go. Got it.
We have little couches now. They're not too bad.
Yeah.
Well, I love Australia. I've been to Perth. I've been to Sydney.
Amazing.
You know, beautiful country.
Have you been up north, like towards Queensland?
No, just Perth and Sydney.
Okay.
You know, you
go
Opera House. I had a chance to see
everywhere.
Shows there. Yeah. I hope to go back.
Go to the Great Barrier Reef as well.
I definitely want to go there.
Yeah,
that's what I've heard. Pretty much that.
We'll give you a discount.
You'll give me a discount.
Yeah, let us know and we'll get you to that reef.
We'll get you that reef discount.
No, thank you.
They're the Reef Brothers.
The Chase Atlantic discount. All right, we're going to ask for some more music if you guys wouldn't mind playing another tune for us. No way.
I didn't even know what we're playing. I need to figure out the key and stuff.
What should we do?
Yeah, you got to tune your saxophone, right?
I just have no idea what I'm playing.
Check. This one's Cassie.
Writing's on the wall right now, and don't wait to involve somehow. Should've probably tore her heart right out. At least that's how it feels right now. Yeah. We're holding on. We say some words, we learn them. Say what you mean, then move it on. She said, 7 in the morning, what you take me for? Cause she's been waiting to know. The drug in her veins is too strong. She fell in love with the medicine she's on. Yeah, in a matter of minutes, her mind's gone, no. Cause she's been waiting too long. Cause she's been waiting too long. It's kinda hard to deal out there. There's way too many feels out there. She said, not if you're a million. I swear I fell in love right there. Yeah, we take it off, we take it off. She'll get me high, but out of cuts. I see it in her eyes, that girl is lost. But Cassie, if you stay with me. Just give that a thought. But she don't ever wanna make no plans. She don't got a sign no more. Oh, yeah. She left a deed in my heart. And she drew with a car into my lifetime. She tells her head to the side. What a nightmare. The car she turns to overdose. That's a perfect dance. Don't you overdose? Oh,
oh. Thank you.
I like it. Nice. Very nice. Clinton, Mitchell, Christian.
Yes.
Chase Atlantic live here on The Voice of America in D.C.
Is that camera still?
Hey.
That camera works too. So you used to record in your bedroom? You had a bedroom studio?
Yeah, we still kind of do sometimes.
We still do.
Honestly, the one of the next tracks that may be coming out, I don't know. Yeah, I can't say anything.
It's fun.
You can't tell me about it, huh?
It's always so good being in the studio and the bedroom have such a difference, because when you're in the studio, you feel more inclined to work harder. And you do write better songs.
You write some better songs.
Yeah. But in the bedroom it's so much more chill and you can be more free.
Uh-huh.
So it's really hard because studio is like pressure. I'm gonna do well. Bedroom's like I can do well. I can just chill out though at the same time. Yeah. No pressure. Mm.
But you know, you had mentioned earlier that you know being with a major usually comes with kind of compromising, sacrificing a little bit of the input and control over your music. But in this case,
it's a thing. That's what we're worried about. We're very picky. So we're like, we're not sacrificing anything. Mm. A lot of labels were like,
We never. Yeah, we had a lot of. I know it sounds a little arrogant, but a lot of labels like coming up to us, especially in Australia, and we just.
Even in America, we had a bunch of meetings.
We just were always under the assumption we can do it ourselves. Like, we had first two EPs we did under Chase Atlantic Records. We were like, we can do it ourselves, and we're not going to sign unless it's 100% what we want. And Warner has been amazing.
And this was even before we were as good as we are now producing. Like, this is when they were like, we're good still, but like we've gotten better, and so I feel like the trust is gaining.
Now, how did you connect with the Madden Brothers? How did they find you?
They slid into our DMs.
Slid right into those DMs. Yeah. Yeah.
They went into our Twitter and just sent us a little DM.
And that's it. I like what you're doing.
They heard some like original tracks that we'd released online.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And they were like, let's do it. Let's work with you guys. And we were like, oh, We got a message actually like a year prior before we actually started hanging out with them. It was like, really like your music, and then we didn't think anything of it.
We didn't
like,
think it was real.
They didn't start their company until the same time we kind of joined them. So
We didn't know what we could do to actually work with them.
Yeah.
And then they just kept, they came to us. They literally like invited us to do so many things.
Very persistent, very awesome.
I imagine they you know, kind of are very helpful in giving you the creative freedom that you have, because if they say leave him alone, then
they give us a studio to work out.
Yeah, they were amazing. But we just at the start, you're just kind of a little bit starstruck, and you're like, you sure you guys want to work?
You sure?
What are you guys
like? We've just been making music in our bedrooms. Like, we didn't do anything. They're like, we love that. We love that about you guys.
And they're awesome. They've become our big brothers, our mentors.
Yeah.
And they're so helpful all the time. They always have the best things to say. And they're real good at making us feel good.
What's the music scene like in Australia? Are you happy with it?
It's
are you
great.
Proud? Or are you thinking?
I'm very proud of it.
Yeah.
I'm just not as proud as of the people need to support the music more in Australia and the underground people.
The popular music in Australia is horrific. The music that they have like more underground, the bands that people listen to, like they have some incredible bands. Mm-hmm. Like insane. Some like literally my favorite bands are from Australia.
Yeah. A lot of our favorite bands, Last Dinosaur, Sticky Fingers, Tame like, Impala.
And like, and you play it for these for these people. You play it to
the worldwide
to Americans, and then these guys like, this music's amazing, like I haven't heard this. It's like no one's heard this.
Yeah, it's because Australians just
don't support
Australians.
It.
Yeah.
It's weird. They're like, they love to go around and be like, oh, I love underground music, but they won't go to shows. That's it. It will change. Yeah. It'll change.
It'll slowly change.
But,
Feel like Australia's definitely slowly adopting more American culture as well towards music.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, but we're happy to have you here in the U.S. for as long as you're here. How long are you going to be here? Are you just for the tour?
We're stuck here forever.
You relocated to the U.S.?
Cross that border.
They took our visas away.
They took our passports
away. We've done the border crossing and now it's over.
That's it. It's all over now. Yeah. Chase Atlantic live here on The Voice of America. If you guys would do another song for us.
Yes. Here we go. Some more. What are we playing? Final one.
The final song.
Rangerine.
Let's make it real beautiful.
Path yourself when and cut the brakes out of my car. If I survive, she'd run it on a sin. If I die, she'll make sure that I'm 6 feet under her.
1, 2, 2.
Angeline, won't you listen to me, please? I don't know what I did, baby. I'm trying to live, baby. So Angeline, no, I'm not trying to cause a scene. But you need to get out of here. All my family thinks you're crazy. Don't know what to do with you. think I'm through too. She ain't chilling. She's been drinking too much tea. Oh, smoking a week, smoking a week, smoking a week.
Nice, nice. From Australia to America to the world, right here on Border Crossings. Woo! Chase Atlantic, it's a pleasure to have you guys in our studios. And I love the hair. I mean, when I first saw it, I thought Flock of Seagulls, you know, from the 80s. I don't know if you know that band. You're going to have to Google it.
He just looks like a flock of seagulls.
He looks like a flock of seagulls. No, they had hair like that, one of the guys in the band. So, yeah, cool. Very, very cool.
Just put a headband over.
Just put a headband.
Been messy this morning, my hair.
So the rest of the tour in the United States, then what happens after the tour? You guys just going to chill for a while, write some more music?
We're going to go back to Aussie, and we're going to do some shows over there. Yeah. We got our very first ever festival, Download Festival.
Oh, mm-hmm. Excellent.
Yeah. And then we're just touring for the rest of the
year. We're touring with Good Charlotte for that like a few shows in Australia, and then again we're Sleeping With Sirens.
Yeah. And we're doing a lot of festivals this year. We've done zero festivals, and we're doing like all of them this year.
All at once.
We've booked easily over 120 shows so far this year. So
fantastic!
It's a big one.
Big if people want to, you know, they follow you Instagram, Twitter. How can
it's
they
all
find
Chase
you?
Atlantic.
It's all Chase
we
Atlantic.
Kept it real simple.
Simple. Chase Atlantic.
Just Chase Atlantic.
Facebook page. Chase
Bank
Atlantic.
In the ocean. Yeah. The bank in the ocean for Americans out there. Right. Chase Bank. Atlantic
Chase
Ocean.
Bank. Atlantic. Oh, Chase
YouTube,
Atlantic.
SoundCloud, Spotify, iTunes Music, what else?
Everything.
Everything. I love your sound, and you guys are a lot of fun, so promise me you'll come back.
Definitely. This is great. This has been fun.
We loved having you on The Voice of America. Nice. Thank you so much. Chase Atlantic, the name of the album and the band. My name is Larry London, and this is Border Crossings.